Welcome back to Let's Play the Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, heading to Folthia, to the Castle Rudo, I believe. It's quite a while. Well, first we have to go to Jurufez and find somebody who's in jail so he can help us, and then ultimately we're going here to Rudo, Castle Rudo. I am passing, thank you. I didn't click him. So, where we're going first is the Dilt Checkpoint, which is not too far. That time I clicked by mistake. Alright, we'll fight you. Goat, Compi, and Salamander. Okay, so she's new, the one on the left. Sorry, that's the right. I know my directions. I think these things run up. I want to attack the same one whenever possible. No, he doesn't have a finishing move. Yeah, he needs another hit first. His name's Badat. He's relatively new, and Stella is brand new. Yeah, she does know magic. Time stop. For herself. It's interesting. Uses a lot of magic points, though. Should we play with it? Let's try the time stop. This looks like a challenging bit of enemies. Because that one ran up. Oh, I didn't get to move. Or attack, rather. Time and space bow before me. Time stop. So, she gets to attack again. Take this. And she gets to attack again. And yet again. I hope I was attacking C. Alright, cool. Let's go to this one. Badat can do his finishing move. Flashing bullets on this salamander bee. Oh, that's different. Sweet. Nice. I'll use Jurio's finishing move at the next battle. Nice. A shielding food and a recure potion, which are probably full of recure potions, I imagine. It only tells you you're full. Oh no, he's full. Well, when you get them in battle, it never tells you that you're full and can't carry anymore. Actually, wait. That was Jurio, never mind. Finishing move. Always got a new one? Brave Rush. I didn't know he got a new finishing move. Let's check Salamander B again. Nice. I'll show you what I can do. Oh, he hit a hole. He hit a bunch. Whoa, that's awesome. I thought it was just going to be against one enemy. Nice. Yeah, I'm pretty happy about that. Chris levels up, level 28. Alright. Some of us could stand to use some healing here. Oh, Chris! Actually, other than that, we're okay. So I think we're just supposed to head straight north. But it makes me curious about what is this way, if anything. Besides more monsters. Oh wait. Yeah, it's Jurio. Never mind. Alright, what's your finishing move? Magic Burst. Let's do it on this salamander here. Something before her arts. Hopefully it hits the other two as well. Nice! Wow, 456 damage. This is a really good team. Shielding food and cure potion. Stella's stuck at level 34 until the other guys catch up. Was curious how many cure potions I have. Okay. Okay, Badat's finishing move. Meet your end by my hand. I hate when the one we want to attack, there it goes. Plays hard to get. That guy was damaged. You're doomed. Thank you. Okay, what is this way? More Gwil Road. There's a north, isn't there? God. Oh, who's this? Desert Merchant. Welcome. I did not know you were here. It looks like we have to go east. A spider knife. This is the only one that could use it. And we use that. Mirage armor. Bad Ant has it. I don't like the Avoidant Zero for Jurio. Yeah, I don't like that. Yeah, I don't like the decreases on the stuff. That's it. Alright. Well, I don't want any of those things in. By the way, do you happen to have all 9 volumes of Safi? It's hard to get a hold of the whole set. A complete collection would be priceless. Jurio says, I have them all. Really? That's great. Can I have the 9 volumes, please? I'll give you something valuable in return. I gotta read those. Yeah, I'm gonna have to read them at a save from before I'm doing this. Wow, thanks! As I promised, I'll give you something valuable in return. Who do you like better in this story, Safi or Brad? I guess we'll get a different cool item. Since I don't know what the items are, I'll respond truthfully, Safi. Jurio exchanged the complete 9 volumes of Safi with Silfing. Are you finding your sword useful? If you have a question, feel free to ask. I can't ask you about it. So that's a sword then? Attack goes down. What is attack now? 278? But avoidance and speed go up. 39 and 55. Alright, 39 and 55. That's pretty good. I wish the attack didn't go down. I mean, 254. I'll use it, but I'm gonna hold on to the ancient sword in case I want him to be hitting harder and not avoiding as much. And not as fast. It's coming. I hate to save right before it's going to come at me. But I must. Let's see, how many of these can we avoid? Whoa! Oh my god! I've got the whole zone after me here. I'm sure there'll be more to fight over here. Let's observe. You're in a bad mood, and you're weak from hunger. Wow. We can fix that. Spicy food. Fire-based attacks. Not so good around here with these things. Because they are fire-based. Organic food. Diet, angel food, sky base, wind based attacks. Figured water would be effective. But, let me get rid of these. Let me use a wind-based attack. You figure wind would be good against fire as well. Diet food for you, sorry. Motivated. Nice. Alright, so... Oh, we can only go this way? Yeah. Uh-oh, who's this? Belart! I've been waiting for you. Thank you so very much for crushing my lofty plan in Fenty. It's Belart, Jurio says. I never forget when I'm humiliated. Chris says, or you're just a spiteful person who holds on to old grudges. How dare you? Badat says, Jurio, were you in trouble in Fenty too? Well, a little. I see you have company now. I'm sorry, but you've chosen your friends poorly. You must die as well. What are you talking about? Says Badat. Stella says, I don't know what happened in Fenty, but I assume Jurio and Chris crushed your evil deed. Something like that. But it wasn't an evil deed. It was a lofty plan. Cut the crap, says Badat. You idiots. You don't even know the current state of affairs. Insult me any way you like. I don't care. Anyway, I've been waiting to settle the score with these two. This time, Master Revas gave me not only wisdom, but also fighting power. Revas? Oops. I shouldn't be talking about that. It's not important to you. You'll die here today. Here I come. Whoopee. Well, this was a surprise. Pet's anger, here you go. I was afraid we wouldn't have a chance to use this stuff on the fire creatures. Let's see how effective it is. Oh, not that effective. At all, really. Finishing move? Oh, no, he doesn't have it yet, never mind. I want to take out the others first. Believe it or not. But I'll have Chris do a finishing move on Belart. And these two can attack this copy here. I was hoping he might one-shot it, but no such luck. Coming through! Alright, one copy down. Belart using Wind Cutter. Oh my god. Finish this thing off. Was he? He was attacking the flame thing, though. I'm not sure which one it was. Ugh. Alright, get that. Magic. Hold up. A small amount for all. I think I want Re-Cure on Chris. These two finish this thing off. Alright, that's done with. Oh, crap. That one's done with. Rock shot Belart. Ow! Yeah. so... I see a Jurio finish. Is Brave Rush good against one enemy? Well, he'll hit the other one, if it's still alive. Chris, do a recure on Jurio. These two just attack Belart. He's closer. Yeah, I should take out the copy. 999 on Belart. Wow, we defeated him. Wow. Chris levels up to 29. Jurio, 31. Badat, 33. Badat has learned first aid. Sweet. And we got a guard ring plus 3. I think this is our first plus 3 ring. Closing monologue? Damn. I won't forget this. I can be revived again and again with the help of Master Revas. Something is wrong. I feel my power being drained. I may have amplified my original power too much with the spell. Oh no. I'm fainting. Ugh. Bye. Jurio says, he can't be revived again, can he? Chris says, I feel a little sorry for him. Badat says, Revas may be a lot more powerful and evil than we think. Stella says, we must hurry. The fact that Belart was waiting for us here means Revas may have learned what we're up to. Badat says, right, we better head for the Fulthia border, quickly. Well, before we do that, let's heal up. Chris with 87. Okay, that's good. Well, I'm glad we were successful there. A most entertaining battle. Anything else in here to attack us? We must be by the checkpoint. Yeah. 37 Milos is basically from the sign to the end of the zone, which is right here. Just like that. 37 Milos. Or Milos, rather. Dilt checkpoint. Let me look around outside here. That's cool, I got a special sword for the Saffy volumes. Alright, we can't... There's nothing out here to see. Fulthia's soldier says, hi, travelers! Are you going to Fulthia? Jurio says, actually, we're returning to Fulthia, where we started our pilgrimage. Oh, my mistake. Sorry. If you're just returning to your hometown, I don't see any problem. You can pass. Is there anything else? What? The border is protected by Fulthia's soldiers based on a treaty with Gadona. There's no conflict here. The Fulthia army is protecting this border for charitable reasons. Hi. Rarely do we get normal travelers. This fortress is filled with tough soldiers from Fulthia sent to guard the border. You should be careful. I'm not afraid of soldiers, says Chris. What'd you say? Who in the world do you think you are? We're protecting the border for you. Oops. Jurio says, right. He's a good example. Watch your mouth. All the soldiers here are tough. Moist says we're not afraid of them. Do you want us to be afraid of you? What kind of protector is that? Hi there. Chris says, hello. None of the soldiers stationed here, excluding myself, are from the elite guard. Everyone is upset for having been sent here without a good explanation. They may be rude, but please forgive them. I'll take it into consideration. But they don't really have me in a very forgiving mood. Why do we have to guard the border of Godona? It's not our job. Jurio says, excuse me? What? Who ordered you to guard the border? Don't ask stupid questions. King Rudolph, of course. King Rudolph? Not Revas? Who? I've never heard of him. Are you accusing me of lying? Don't insult me, you stupid boy. Oh boy. Nice. Real nice. I can't see. Next, please. Jurio says, we are on our way back from pilgrimage. Pilgrimage? Chris says, you don't know? So what? Sorry, I'm ignorant. Oops, he's scary. Badat says, hey, you don't have to raise your voice like that. Shut up. You have a problem? Huh, guess I won't let you pass. That's not fair, says Jurio. I don't care. I am the officer in charge of this checkpoint. I have the most authority here. Is that so? Says Stella. That's so cool. I love a man with power. Well, really? I'm flattered. Can we pass, please? You said you were on your way back from pilgrimage? Alright, you can pass. Please, go ahead. Jurio showed him the silver dagger as a formality. Checked. Okay. When the transfer bridges are connected, cross to the Fulthia side and show it again to the officer at the exit. That'll do. Thank you, says Stella. You look dashing. Am I? Aw, shucks. That's funny. All you have to do is give him compliments. Alright, so there's no one else to talk to. Not that they're very nice to talk to. Oh, he just found something too. Hate when that happens. Are you traveling to Fulthia? Badat says yes. The transfer bridges are not connected yet. Could you please kill some time in the lobby on the east side? Chris says the lobby on the east side? Okay. I'll call you when the bridges are connected. Alright, what if we go to the west side instead? Chris says he told us to wait in the lobby on the southeast side. We shouldn't be walking around. Actually, he said east side, not southeast side. But I want to talk to whoever that is over there. Oh well. I'll call you when the bridges are connected. Wait in the lobby in the meantime. Don't wander about, alright? But that's what we do, we wander about. Don't talk to the prisoners. They're in prison because they committed crimes. We have no time to listen to what any criminals have to say. Don't associate with the prisoners. It's for your own good. Well, we must talk to them then. Pools says, hey guys, yo, what's up? This is such a stinking place. I stepped on a soldier's foot by mistake, and they put me here. I can't say this out loud, but these soldiers are pretty agitated. You should be careful, too. Huh. I don't know if he has anything new to say now that we talked to him. Yeah. Aof says, yo, listen. Listen to me, will ya? You may not believe me, but sometimes I hear sound from below the prison floor. Do you think there are big moles down there? I'm sure. There are big moles. Okay. Nobody here. I see your travelers going to Fothia. The transfer bridges are connected only at scheduled times, so relax and wait here. Badat says, the soldiers here are certainly tough, but they're not behaving suspiciously. Stella says, but the number of soldiers here is not normal. Jurio says, everywhere we look, we see soldiers. They are also look very tense, says Chris. Badat says, maybe something terrible is happening on the other side of the bridge in Fothia. Something terrible? Jurio says. I don't know. We'll know once the bridges are connected, and we get there. Chris says, I feel uneasy just waiting here until the bridge is connected. Why don't we check the situation here a little bit? Yeah, says Badat, that's a good idea. Well, you're the one who told us not to wander around. Should we talk to these people again? Big moles. Agitated. It's a boring job to watch these crooks. Inside the lobby, new. Associate with the prisoners. So now we can go up here? You were the one who stopped us before, Chris. Captain Uko says, where are they now? Jurio goes, huh? Oh, we're listening in. The troops that left Castle Rudo are about to arrive at the northern border. The captain says, the elite troops from the castle, they're different from those of us who are guarding remote areas. We don't need them here. I don't know what King Rudolph is thinking. We've got enough soldiers already. The soldier says, the troops will stand by on the north side until further instructions come from the castle. I wonder what kind of instructions they're waiting for. The captain says, I have no idea. I don't really want to know. The soldier says, we can't be waging a war against the world or something, can we? Uko says, do you think so too? Uh-oh. The soldier says, hey, what are you doing here? Were you eavesdropping on us? Captain! Captain says, bring them here. Go in. Quickly, the soldier says. Oh, you pushed us. The captain says, I'm sorry, but since you heard us talking, I can't let you go. Chris says, we didn't hear anything. We didn't hear anything about troops coming from Castle Rudo. Chris! Badat calls her an idiot. Oh my, nice. Jurio says, she always talks a little too much. It's none of your business, says Chris. Captain says, I'll decide to do what to do with them later. Put them in prison for now. Prison again? That's exactly what I was about to say, Chris says. Xella says, it's my first time. Not wanting to fight the soldiers, they were put in the prison at the Fothia border.